Hi Harpers, I'm Tiffany Schaefer, here to empower you to arrange and play Celtic music, and today we're going to learn an easy tune by ear called the Skye Boat Song. So I'm going to teach it to you phrase by phrase and give you an idea of the chords you might play, and if you'd like some help in arranging this, I've got an interesting piece of sheet music for you in the description you can get. It is the whole entire tune written out twice, once high, once low. If you have a small harp, you can play it up high. And it's got a blank bass line for you to write in your own arrangement. And it also comes with a sheet of patterns for you to use. Some of them are easy, some of them are more advanced, and you can mix and match and use it as a springboard for your own ideas to arrange this simple tune. If you want some help learning those patterns and get some more ideas for chords you could play, you can check out my lessons on Patreon. Those are linked below in the description as well. One for beginner harpers and one for more advanced harpers. And pledging for those rewards on Patreon helps support this channel if you are finding value in it, so thank you to all of my current patrons. If you want to hear this tune played all the way through and how I've chosen to put together some of these patterns that I've given you, you can click up here in the cards and watch the playthrough video. Before we start, make sure you subscribe because next week I'm going to be doing a bonus episode of Tune Tutor, a very special one on YouTube Live, so please don't miss that. Otherwise, let's get started learning the Skye Boat Song. So we're in the key of G, we have our Fs sharped and nothing else. And my advice for learning a tune by ear is not to worry too much about the fingering right away. Use what you already know and can intuitively put in, but otherwise try and get the melody with your ear. Keep in mind what thirds sound like on your harp, what seconds sound like right next to each other, what fourths sound like, what fifths sound like, and try and see if you can identify those without looking. So I'm going to play a line first, and just as an experiment, I'm going to blank my screen to see if you can find the first note we're starting on without looking. So here's our beginning note. Pluck around your harp. Did you find it? You're right, we're starting on a D. Now try and listen to this next interval. Could you find that? Great. I'm going to show you the next note now. Listen to it again. So if you know your intervals, you'll know that we've played a second back and forth, starting on that D, and then we've jumped from the D a fourth up. And you know it's a fourth because it sounds like Here Comes the Bride. Right? I'll turn my camera back on now. And the way I do the fingering for this right now is 2-1-2. And before you move that thumb, before you play that 2 again, just bring your thumb up to that fourth, that G. So just so we connect the phrase. Here's the phrase again. Great. So I'd like to challenge you to learn the whole tune this way without looking so much as my fingers, as much as you listen with your ears. So let's learn the next phrase. There's a lot of more seconds, notes really close together. So you know we're starting on a G. I'm using fingers 3-2-1 just to start with. And then you have the same fingering in the same exact same shape we started with. A second back and forth, and then up to an interval of a fourth. Right? So let's put these two phrases together. We'll start with D and E.
another G. Make sure you bring that thumb up nice and early. Pretty much as soon as you're done playing that B, the thumb can start going up to that D. Great. So get that phrase very comfortable in your minds and let's move on. So if you weren't looking, you can tell there we have a wide jump that we haven't had before. First, it starts with more seconds. Those are very close together. If you like, you can hear that is a fifth. From B down to E. And we almost always pretty much play fifths with one and three. So make sure you do that fingering. So here's that phrase again. We're gonna start with a B down to the A. Now this is the same reverse sort of overlapping brackets, right? Before we were making sure that our thumb went up early. Now we're gonna make sure that our third finger goes down to that E early. We're gonna start with thumb and second on B and A. And before that B plays, make sure your third finger is ready on E, so you don't get lost. When you connect this way, you'll ensure that you don't have to look at your right hand so much and you can focus more on what your left hand is doing. Great, let's put all three of these phrases together. Oh, first, I lied, we're gonna learn the very last one because it's really easy. See if you can get this without watching. We ended up on the same note we started on. And they're a second, very close together, E to D. So again, from that new phrase, B to A. So let's start from the beginning and put this together. This, once you've played it twice, is the entirety of the A part of the chorus. This song starts with the chorus. So we're going to start from D and we're going to play this through. We'll just play it once. At the end, we'll go back and play everything in order. One, two, three. One, two, three. Then we just start it over. All right, so now let's learn the B part. Again, I want to challenge you to not look. Either turn off your computer screen and just listen or turn around. And let's start with on a B. I'll let you know the B part starts on a B. That's easy to remember. And listen for the intervals. Did you get that? You'll know that's a third. It's not close together, right? It's a little bit farther. And then this next one, that's a bit farther than a third, isn't it? There's our fourth again, right? So let's put these together, starting from B to G. You generally, if you can, want to avoid playing the same note in a row with the same finger. If I do all of those with my thumb, it just gets a bit awkward. I, for one thing, have nothing to hang on to, so I might miss and hit the wrong string. And it can be just a little straining on my thumb. So let's try doing 1-2-1-2 here. And then come back and hit that second B with a 2. 1-2-1-2. It's much more freeing, and then make sure you lift off and relax right after that. And let's play the next one, same way. This fourth, A to E. 1-2-1-2. Great. Now we're gonna do the same thing. Here's another third. So let's hear that again. Starts on a G. So you notice you have three G's in a row there. We'll start with a G. Second finger, and then another one with one. So I'm fingering that 1-2-1-2, 1-2. Then we simply just repeat that. Here we go. B to G. Now we have a fourth. Now we have a third again. And then finally, when you repeat it, you can end on a D. So you could do this fingering here. 1-2-1-2, 1-2-3, and 3. Finger 3. So let's play that all together again. You could play this, especially if you have a small harp, you could play it an octave higher. Same fingering. But let's play this in the middle for now, and we'll just do all of it together, the whole melody. 1-2-3, 1-2-3. If you like. You usually will end with that chorus again. However many verses you play, you'll end with that major chorus. Let's look really quickly at some chords, bass notes that you might choose to put with this, and you can make up your own left hand, or you can look in the sheet music and look at the patterns I've given you if you want a jump start. So just some basic chords you might choose to put with this. Start with G because we're in our home key of G. Do something with C and something with D once you get to this high D. Back to G here, C here. Oh, I didn't do my right fingering. I'm gonna make sure I use my 3. G and 3, something with C there. Back to G. You could then do D as you go back into the next time. Back to G. C here. D. do a D going into the verses. So for this part, this is a minor, the minor section, and we're gonna start with E minor. So you might do something with an E minor here. Here you can use an A minor. E here. C here. And back to E. Same thing. E. A minor. And back to C. Finally an E, and then as you go to this D, you want to do something with D. There. Hope that gets you started. Thanks for learning this tune with me. If you liked it, please leave it a thumbs up. That helps me out. And you can also leave a comment and let me know if you like this sheet music idea of arranging it yourself. Patterns. If you liked that tutorial, you might like my playlist of easy tune tutors, and you can click this playlist right here to get to those. Make sure you click my face and subscribe so you don't miss next week's special bonus live tune tutor. And Patreon is right over here if you want to access those rewards like monthly sheet music or the lessons that teach these left-hand patterns by ear. I'll see you next week. Bye!